Hi everyone, Adesh here. So today we'll talk about PCA 9685 board, which is a 16-pin PWM board where we can configure many boards, almost like 64 boards in the chain with the address configurations. So let's see how the board looks like. Basically, this board is used for driving servo. But we can use it for other purpose later on in the tutorial. I'll tell you how we can use it for other purposes also with the APIs. Let's see how board looks like. So this is how you can see the board is. So where we can see we have a pins here, like we have a GND pin, we have SCL and SDA pin, serial data, serial clock line, serial data line, VCC, which is 5 volt plus line, and this is plus VC, which is 5 volt. This pin as well as this VC, this pin are connected with each other. Here you can see we have 0 to 15 pins here in the row continuously. I'm not sure you can see it, probably you can see it now. From 0 to 15 you can see here, and here in this you can see here these are the address configurations: A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. So with this you can do the address configuration. Unlike the other board, which is PCF board, where you have a jumper, here you don't have jumper, here you have to do the soldering. So you have to solder between the high and low. This is here, once we solder it, it will generate another address. We'll talk about that also later in this. Here you can see this is yellow lines are pulse width modulations line, red one is a plus 5 volt, and black one pins are GND pins. Here you can see here you have the same pins like GND, SCL, SDA, VCC, and V plus. We have OE line also, which we barely use it. So what we have to do, we have to get something, get a connector like this. Here in the video you can see it, some connector like this, and you have to do the soldering to the end of the board. So you can like this, you have to just set it and you have to solder it, and you have to do the soldering. And once this is soldered into this will looks like something like this. Here you can see you can take something like this hole, where you don't so what you will do, whenever you need an additional board, you will go and you will just create a chain like this with the different address configurations. So let's see how the addresses can be done, address configurations can be done via soldering here. So here you can see like we have A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. So right now if you see the board here, nothing has been soldered here, all like this, plus this, both the points are not joined together. But once you start doing soldering, you will get the different address configurations. So by default, the address when it is not soldered, it is 40 in hexadecimal 40, and once you start soldering A1, A0, it will give you 41. So if I have a already soldered board here, if you can see here, this board is already soldered here, A0. So this board has address 40. If you solder on A1, if you see here another board, you see another board here. So sorry, A1. So if you solder this, it will give you a address, and this will be 40, 41, 42. And if you solder A0 and A1, it will give you 43 address. So like that, if you see here the sheet, So like that, I have already added the sheet here. Like if nothing is ordered, it's 40. If A0 is ordered, it's 41. If A1 is ordered, it's 42. If A1 and A0 is ordered, it's 43. If A2 is ordered, it's 44. Like that, we can configure almost 64 boards in the row, and we can have 64 into. We can have 64 into 16, which will be 1024 pins for operation. So how we have to do in chain like this, if you see, this is a POS board which has, I'll show you in, this is a POS board where we nothing is ordered. So this is a 40 board, and if A0 is ordered, which is this board, which will be 41. And if we see A1 is order, which will be 42. Like that, we'll keep snapping, and when A0 and A1 is ordered, it will be 43. So if you see the boards, I do the zoom out, you can see here. So like that, we can just add the boards in the chain. So if we see here, if we take this board, if we talk about this, so here you can see here we have additional 5 volt plus and GND here, GND pin. So this 5 volt plus this, both are connected internally. So we can do a different way. There are multiple ways of connecting that with each other in that sense. We have to supply the power to that. So I'll show you how we can do. There are ways for doing that. If you see, this is a first board, only single board. So we can provide 5 volt input to the board from the sideway, and we can provide ST and SCL from the Mega or Uno, and we can provide 5 volt plus and GND to the pin, PC8 9685 pin here, and we can connect like PWM positive and minus for the servo and for different operation. When we do the chaining, we can do in this way same. We have to just add it in the behind, and we can pass in the second board also. We can pass like from the sideboard, we can pass plus and plus 5 volt as well as GND. And there's another way, like where we'll, it's like same as the first one, but in the second approach where we are just passing the external power supply to the first board, because as I have mentioned that this 5 volt V5 is connected to that, so it will by default it will pass to the all the boards in the chain. So that's how this board is configured, the different styles. I have a GitHub page, which is github.com/adarshkumarsingh83/onvino/document/PCA9685. You can visit to that page. You can visit to this page here, and you can see here all other informations, how to configure the board and style, which will be helpful for you for using this board with the servo or for other operations. So later in the video we'll see how we can use it for other operations like LEDs or for servers together. So I guess that's it for now. Thank you.